Now, if you didn't get the chance to take advantage of those post-holiday deals, you still have a chance. Most stores, like Target, are staying open later this evening to accommodate shoppers. In other consumer news, warmer than usual weather saved a lot of us from high heating bills in November, but brace yourself for the new year. Higher heating bills are on the way. The Michigan Public Service Commission last week approved gas price increases requested by MichCon and Consumers Energy. In addition, Consumers has asked the MPSC for another increase. If that's approved, customers will see a hike anywhere from $25 to $75. Of course, all of this depends on the weather. If you need help paying your bill, Consumers Energy and the Salvation Army have a program called People Care. The program will provide over $1 million in bill credits. Now, if you would like to donate to the program, check the box at the top of your January bill, and you can give $1 a month or a one-time donation of $5. Our volunteers have been able to help some of our viewing area, and we did get the opportunity to talk to one of those individuals today.
I think it's kind of cool that they're giving me money back, you know. It's not a lot, but it's money that I didn't count for, you know, so to me it's like free money.
James Zimmer is one of hundreds of Michigan residents who called our tax refund hotline and found out his name is on the list. This last year, he married and moved, and in spite of changing his address with the post office, he never received his government rebate check in the mail.
I called the post office like four times. They're like, well, if you got a forwarding address, then it should come there, you know? So yeah, I got a forward address.
But a lot of the IRS checks were never forwarded. Instead, returned to sender.
How did the system get so... I mean, that's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money, and like I say, most of it has to do with people moving or not changing their address with us.
If you move, you need to notify the IRS by filling out Form 8822. We picked one up for James at the local IRS office. But he even called the IRS personally to make sure that his new address is on file.
Well, anything you want to say to the fact that, you know, we found the money for you today?
Yeah, that's cool. Give it to me, you know.
When I asked him what he was going to do with the money, he said, pay bills, which is not a bad thing to do. Now, we are going to be taking phone calls until 6:30 this evening, so all you have to do is call 1-800-257-8943 to see if your name is on that list. And speaking of the list, I'm going to name off two area residents that we have here. We have John James Cameron of Bay City, and we have Jason Trish of Caro, and we're going to be checking back a little bit later in the show. Children can spend hours and hours playing with toys, and sometimes the things they get their hands on end up in their mouth. This is what concerned the father of 3-year-old Connor and 4-year-old Caleb. Jerry Shaw was putting together two tackle boxes given to the boys as birthday gifts. Something on the box lured him in to take a closer look.
When I first opened it and I started putting it together for the children, I noticed the tag on the back, and as I started reading the tag more, it got to the point that I couldn't believe what I was reading.
Reading, warning. This product contains a chemical known to the state of California to cause cancer and birth defects and other reproductive harm. Do not place your hands in your mouth after handling the product. Do not place the product in your mouth. Wash your hands after touching this product. And inside the box, right next to the stickers, another similar warning label. But this one says, warning, this product contains lead.
This is alarming.
It is. It just is sort of frightening, actually.
Jerry immediately took the boxes away from his children, but he worried that when he returned the tackle boxes to Walmart, that they would just end up back on the shelf, sold again and back in the hands of another child. So that's when he called us.
I'd like to see them, you know, taken care of so that if the child wants to go fishing, he doesn't have to worry more what's in the box than what's in the water.
According to the Consumer Product Safety Commission, because lead accumulates in the body, even exposures to small amounts of lead can present health risks. That is why the CPSC is pushing the Federal Hazard Substance Act, which states toys or other articles intended for children that expose children to hazardous amounts of lead are banned.
I called the company that manufactures these toolboxes, and I spoke with the president of Jadeco Incorporated. After I told the president about the concerns of lead and the CPSC's request that all toy manufacturers eliminate lead from the product, well, he was concerned. And because of our investigation, These tackle boxes will no longer be sold with lead inside.
The president, Randy Dickerson, told us, quote, "As we speak, Jadeco Incorporated is making a change in direction. The product will be refined. Within the next 45 days, new tackle boxes will be on the market. They will no longer contain lead sinkers. Instead, the sinkers will be made out of a product that is called bismuth, an ingredient in Pepto-Bismol," end quote. Dickerson also agreed with us to voluntarily replace all current tackle boxes on the market right now with a free replacement box, something Jerry was hoping would happen to not only protect his kids, but others out there as well.
Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us, everyone. I'm Diane Sitek. Janice is off today. As many celebrate the new year, one local community is mourning over the deaths of two teenagers. They were hit by a car last night while walking home from a New Year's Eve party. It happened on Curtis Road near DeMel Road in Frankenmuth Township at about 10 last night. Police officers were on the scene this afternoon reconstructing the accident.